Yes, hi, and thank you for the opportunity to present my submission for hackathon. My name is Saurabh. I work in the M365 team at AFRI in Stockholm. We at AFRI have a feature-rich custom-built intranet, which is, well, not on SharePoint. And this hackathon gave me an opportunity to put forward the case of a SharePoint-based intranet. I could closely follow what others are building. Those cool solutions were inspiration for me to put up a presentation. And then I could also build a POC, which brings in some of the features that we have, and also the concerns were addressed with this, which led to a custom-built intranet in the first place. I started with finding out why custom intranet, first of all, and then reasons were not surprising at all. When we started building, SharePoint Online was not available, and 2010 on-prem in general had limitations that we all know. Integrations were difficult. We were focused on microservices architecture since 2015, or so I'm told, and it was difficult to implement in on-prem. Then external access was hard, and customization was difficult as well. And we all spent a lot of time in building SharePoint, not look like SharePoint. And these were one of the, like, some of the reasons that we built custom intranet. Some of the reasons are not valid anymore. I'm not sure about microservice architecture, but most of the customization we build now are independent cloud hosted services, which we integrate with SharePoint. So I think that is addressed as well. So for my POC, this is what I was trying to address, all these concerns. And also, this is a slide taken from my presentation, internal presentation, where I wanted to highlight what SharePoint brings today. These are the capabilities that are not new for Microsoft 365 community, but they're often overlooked by those outside it. And what I did was a quick reminder or demo to highlight just how much innovations we're missing out by not having intranet on SharePoint. Also, for my hackathon work, I picked a few of the features from here just to create some quick solution. And the key was the tons of sample we have available. Those are almost production ready for everything that would want to build, and that's what made possible for me to complete my hackathon work as well as the POC for a company. Now I'll move to the demo. This is the SharePoint intranet landing page. The first thing that you'd see when you come to the page is this pop-up, which is part of a guided site tour. And this one talks about every component that we have on the page, and users can use this to understand what is built. This is taken from one of the sample that we have, but enhanced for my needs. The first thing that you see is that the welcome message, and then you have option to disable it from subsequent load, so it will not appear when you click. You can use click or keyboard left and right arrow to navigate to different elements on the page, and then understand what those are for. The steps are configured in a SharePoint list. The description is in a rich text where you can use images, rich text, videos as well. And then the steps you target to different element on the page using selectors. Selectors could be web part ID, instance ID, the HTML element ID class, or even web part titles. You can choose in which order this step needs to appear and for what language. The language is picked up automatically by users' preferred language, and the step is displayed in that language. If you have disabled it, you can, you always have option to click on this button and open it. And admins can again reset the choice for users once there are new addition to the page. And the first component of the page you see is the welcome card. The welcome card greets users based on the time of the day. On the left-hand side, there's a picture. Clicking on the picture takes you to the Microsoft 365 profile card. Two buttons, one is for the site guided tour that you just saw, and the second one is for a feedback, for you to share your thoughts. The feedback could be feedback, bugs, or feature requests, and these trigger different flows. If it is a negative feedback, the sentiment analysis is done, and then it sends a mail to the product team. Bugs are reported in DevOps, and the feedbacks are reviewed periodically by the team. Also, you can simply like or dislike any component on the page by clicking these buttons, if need be. Then you have just the last password change. I have not changed my password since I've got this account, but if I should, and I can click on this link to change it. Then there is a AI-powered email and upcoming event summary, and this is done using SPFX and Azure function. In SPFX component, we get the upcoming events and email from Graph API. Pass that in a request body to Azure Function API, and then in Azure Function using Azure OpenAI chat client, we generate the summary in a natural language. On the right-hand side, there is a unified notification system, which consolidates notifications from various systems we have in the company. This is primarily integration work where notifications are basically retrieved from different systems using pull or push mechanism. Yeah, and then those notifications are stored in a ADLS for cleanup, and from there they push to Cosmos DB, and from there the APIs are created to do various action, one to read, and then there are users can click or close, read it or close a notification. The last item on this card is a quick link, and these are my favorite links that I need for my work. The links are pushed by company. Most of the links on the left-hand side that you see, those are grouped in different categories. As a user, I can mark them and make them my favorite. And those favorite links will come here, and the same links will appear here. I can also add my custom links, and those links will come with default icon, and they'll become favorite by default. The next section is news and events. For news, I'll skip this one for now. But for news, the biggest win for us has been getting a notification in Teams when the news is published and people have followed the site, and that is a big difference than what we have currently in the company. The next section is employee focus, where we have the connection dashboard cards. I created one or two. I don't have those on the page at the moment, but then the next one is dashboard that users can pick and choose widgets from. So this is a custom SharePoint framework built dashboard where widgets are created in SharePoint list, and then the widgets are created in this format. So you have a title, then you specify the icon, and the templates are handlebar templates, which are for display as well as for error. Those are created, and then the API. It supports, this component supports invoking APIs, public SharePoint SharePoint REST API, Graph API, or API secured with enterprise, Entra ID. And the data from these APIs are then using handlebar service, and using this template, they are compiled, and then HTML is returned and added here. So this is quite useful when we have to show a lot of widgets, and then users can pick and choose based on their needs. They can Yeah, they can add more. They can change the order in which order it should appear, and then those widgets will come here. And then, yeah, some out of the box web part for our assignments, jobs, and connection. This one also has a SharePoint agent, and which is quite useful, and for our users basically, because we have had issues where users have struggled to find forms. They take hours to find a form, and it only takes a few minutes to fill. And we needed to consolidate all those forms, make them available, and then those forms can be searched from a SharePoint agent. Yeah, and it'll show where the form is, and also basic steps how users can submit those forms. Yes, and that is it for the demo. A lot of custom components. I'll not show any code today in the interest of time. But if you are interested, please let me know. Thank you so much.